Hi guys, okay, we're back. I have these little containers that I got from Ralph's, but you can get them from everywhere. They're generic. They come in a pack of six, which is great. We use these for our meal prep. I have a digital scale. I think most scales nowadays are digital. It makes it easy for taking the guesswork out. If you don't have a digital scale, no problem. 4 ounces of meat is about the size of your palm. So I'm gonna start with like guessing these four pieces. That's 3 ounces, so I was close. Add one more piece. So that's what 4 ounces of chicken looks like. So I'm gonna put all my chicken, because I need this container here to roast our sweet potatoes, but I wanna measure out my chicken so that we can get those sweet potatoes roasted. We're gonna add spinach with these guys. And that'll be one of our meals for the week. So it'll be all set and ready to go. So we start by, again, if you don't have a food scale, you can eyeball it. If it fits in the palm of your hand, it's probably 4 ounces. We're gonna do the same thing with our mahi-mahi that came out of the oven. These are some pretty big chunks I did there. That's perfect.
So you mentioned the vegetables. Do you cook the chicken too? I'm sorry, do you cook the spinach also?
I do not pre-cook the spinach. I'm gonna throw the spinach in here.
You wanna cook the chicken though.
We cook the chicken, but we are not going to cook our spinach because when we reheat them, it is going to heat perfectly. Like it won't be mushy. It won't be your grandma's spinach. And then that way, if you choose to eat it cold, like a chicken salad, like a spinach salad with chicken breast, you can. So I'll just put my cup of spinach right in here with the sweet potatoes. So perfect. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I have a couple bonus containers. I'm going to give this a rinse. I already had a cooked chicken on it. We're going to rinse this guy. I feel like I need one more Camper Chef can so that we don't have to clean until the very end. We're going to give it a quick wash so we can put our sweet potatoes on there. Do you want to show them how we prep them?
Okay. So our sweet potatoes are right here. What I did was I took a normal potato peeler. If you never used sweet potatoes before, a normal potato peeler. I peeled them, cut off the edges. Off the ends like this. You see they're all right here. And then getting them about the right diameter, all about the same diameter so they cook evenly. Cut them into slices and then cubes. And then we added about a palmful of garlic powder. And then about a half palmful of black pepper. And for something about this size, and
this was just, 4 sweet potatoes.
This was 4 sweet potatoes. We added about 1/4 cup of olive oil so that they're coated, and then some sea salt. And that's all you had to do to make them. From here, we just put them onto the baking sheet. It's important you want them to be even on the baking sheet. You don't want them to be stacked up there.
So you don't want multiple layers. So with this amount, it's probably going to go on 2 trays because we have enough for 2 people here. So again, this may, if you're not prepping for your whole family, you're probably only going to need two large yams or sweet potatoes. You could get the white or the orange. It doesn't matter. And you're probably only going to, if they're a good size, you're probably only going to need 2. And if they're small, you might need 3. Because this was 4 or 5, but they were really small guys. And that's it. They're going to go in the oven, 375, for about a half an hour. Check them at 20 minutes. If you put your fork through them, they're done. You don't want them firm, but you don't want them mushy either. All right, and we're going to show you how to make the breakfast quinoa in just a second.